everybody, and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you how to crochet these super cute little fat squashy amigurumi pumpkins. If this is your first visit to my channel, it would be amazing if you just took a moment to hit that subscribe button and the bell notification so you don't miss out on any of my future crochet videos. The yarn information, materials you need, and the written pattern are all in the description box below. So if you click show more to expand that box, you'll find everything you could possibly need all written down there waiting for you. So the materials you need to make yourself a little fat squashy pumpkin are, first of all, some chunky yarn in pumpkin-y style colours. So for this chap, I'm using a chunky Stylecraft Special in the colourway Spice, and you'll also need some chunky brown for his little stem. So I'm using Signet Chunky in shade Chocolate for that. Now, because this is amigurumi, the recommended hook size for this yarn is actually a 6mm crochet hook, but for amigurumi, you want small tight stitches. So completely ignore that and go smaller. We're going to be using a 4mm crochet hook. So whatever yarn you are using, go down probably two hook sizes, because there's quite a lot of pressure put on these when we're sort of stitching and stuffing and whatnot, and you do not want your stitches to show. So the best way to do that, smaller hook, a hook that is almost uncomfortably too small for the yarn you're using, then you know you're on the right track. You're also going to need some scissors, stitch marker, which is of course optional but definitely recommended for any sort of amigurumi projects. You're going to need a large eye needle. You're going to need some 10mm safety eyes. You're also going to need a tiny scrap of black yarn to do his little smiley face. And last but not least, you're going to need some stuffing. So without any further ado, let's crack on and start making our adorable little pumpkins. So with my 4mm crochet hook and my chunky sort of rusty orange coloured yarn, we're going to go ahead and do a magic ring. Now, if you don't know how to do a magic ring, I do have a video on how to do exactly that, which I've linked to in the description box below, or a little eye will have popped up here. Or alternatively, you can chain two and work all the following stitches for the first round into that very first chain. So with my magic ring, I'm going to go ahead, chain one, which does not count as a stitch. And I'm going to place six single crochet into the ring. Now, if you want to use a stitch marker, you can, and the point at which to pop it in would be into that very first single crochet. So I've done one, now I need five more. So once you have your six single crochet, you can go ahead and close your magic ring, but don't pull it too tight just yet. I'm going to remove my stitch marker from that very first stitch. Before you fully close the magic ring, we're going to begin round two. So round two is an increase round, which means you're going to place two single crochet into each of those six stitches around, so you will have 12 single crochet by the end of row two. Now mark your first stitch, and at that point you can cinch up the magic ring. So I'm going to pop in my first single crochet of round two, pop in that stitch marker, cinch up the ring at the back, and then place my second single crochet into the exact same stitch. So I've got two single crochet, now increase in the next five stitches. For the next round, we're going to place a single crochet in that very first stitch. Then increase in the next, and then increase two single crochet in the same stitch. And you're going to repeat that all the way around. Single crochet, increase, single crochet, increase, single crochet, increase, all the way around. You will have 18 stitches in total by the end of this round. For the next round, start with a single crochet, mark that first stitch, place a single crochet in the next stitch, then increase in that third stitch. And you're going to repeat that all the way around. Single crochet, then increase, single, single, increase, all the way around. And at the end of this row, you'll have 24 single crochet stitches. For your next round, you're going to start with a single crochet in the first stitch and mark it. Then place a single crochet in the next two stitches. Then increase in the next. And we're going to continue this all the way around. Single crochet in three stitches, then increase in the fourth. By the end of this round, you will have 30 stitches. For the next round, we're going to start with four single crochet in the next four stitches. So do your first one, mark it, then single crochet in the next three stitches. So you're starting with four single crochet, then increase in the next. You're going to repeat this all the way around, single crochet in four stitches, then increase. By the end of this round, you'll have 36 single crochet. For your next round, we're going to start with five single crochet, then increase. So do your first one and mark it with the stitch marker. Stitch marker is of course optional, but it makes it a lot easier to remember where the beginning of your round is. So I've done one, I'm going to do four more single crochet. Then increase. So you're going to continue this around, five single crochet, then increase all the way around, and at the end of this row you'll have 42 stitches. Your next row is going to be our last increasing round. We're going to start with six single crochet, then increase. So do your first one, mark it. And do five more. So you've got six single crochet, then increase, and you're going to repeat that all the way around. Six single crochet, increase, for a total of 48 stitches. So we're done increasing for now. So what we're going to do for the next eight rounds is one single crochet in every single stitch around. So 48 stitches per round, and I need you to go around eight times. So you go ahead and do eight rows of single crochet in every single stitch. And I will meet you back here in just a moment once I have done my eight rows. Don't forget to move your stitch marker for each row and to keep track. So eight rows of single crochet stitches, 48 stitches per row. All right, so that's my final single crochet of my eighth round. So you should have, it's kind of hard to show you in shot, but you should now have a sort of basket bowl going on. So I just took my hook out and pulled up a loop purely so I don't lose this stitch. Now we're going to take a moment to just add the safety eyes. So where your stitch marker is and this final stitch, this is the back of your pumpkin. So you want to spin that round so that's at the back. Go ahead and grab your safety eyes. Okay, so this bit is at the back and we're going to be placing our safety eyes at the front, just a couple of rows down from this final row we've just done. Now, try and find the sort of hexagonal increase points on the bottom. Hopefully you can kind of see them in your own work. You've got like a sort of hexagonal thing going on. You want to follow that up and round, so you know that this area in the middle here is inside this sort of triangle. I hope I am making sense. So follow these lines, draw out with your hands, and you know that you want your eyes to be in this section here. So with my first eye, I haven't moved my thumb from that sort of increase mark here. Not this row we have just done, but the row below, I'm going to go ahead and pop in a safety eye. Right about there, and then I'm going to count six stitches across. So I'm actually going to count the little holes here rather than the stitches or the stitches above, but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I want that gap So I'm then going to put my eye in the next. So you've got 6 stitches, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 in between your safety eyes. So when you're happy with the placement, you can go ahead and pop the safety backs on. Then grab some black and a needle, just a scrap of black, so we can just embroider the mouth. So bring your needle in line with where your eyes are. I want mine to stretch across 4 stitches. So I'm going to bring my needle out here. So 1 full stitch across, leave a tail on the inside and run a straight line 4 stitches along and pop it back in. Then bring your needle in the next sort of row below, but in the middle. Go underneath that black loop and go straight back into that same stitch that you just came from. Pull it down and you'll get a little smiley mouth. When you're happy with the little smiley mouth, you can knot these 2 ends at the back on the inside and trim those off. Then rotate him back round, pop your hook back in that loop, and we're ready to begin our decrease rounds. So for our first decrease row, we're going to be doing invisible decreases, which I will show you a couple of times how to do. But to start, you're going to start with 6 single crochet. Then to do an invisible decrease, you're going to pick up the front loop of the next stitch and the front loop of the stitch after that. Yarn over, pull through those 2 loops, and then complete your single crochet as normal. So again, 6 single crochet. Then invisible decrease by picking up the front loops of the next 2 stitches and complete your single crochet. So at the end of this row, you'll have 42 stitches. For your next row, you're going to do 5 single crochet, then invisible decrease. Repeat that all the way around, 5 single crochet, invisible decrease, and at the end of this row you'll have 36 stitches. For your next row, 4 single crochet, then invisible decrease all the way around, and you will have a total of 30 stitches. For your next row, or round, I should say, we're going to be doing 3 single crochet, then invisible decrease all the way around, so you'll have 24 stitches. For the next round, 2 single crochet, then decrease all the way around for 18 stitches. Now pull a loop of yarn up and pop your stitch marker in that loop so that you don't pull it back through, because we're now going to stuff our little pumpkin friends. So grab your stuffing and put some stuffing in and focus the stuffing around this midsection rather than at the bottom or the top, because we're going to be shaping him so his bottom and his top head inwards. So pop some stuffing, a little less than you think you're going to need, mainly in the main body of your little pumpkin. And when stuffing around the eyes, just make sure I'm kind of shaping it with my hands, that you're not knocking the backs of the safety eyes so that you're making the eyes go sort of skew with. Just pay careful attention around the face area that you're doing a good job of the stuffing and not distorting him. Okay, so once you have a sort of fat lozenge shape, like a squashed orange. You don't want him too round, because of course a pumpkin is sort of a flattened top and bottom. Draw this loop back up that you had your stitch marker in and put your hook back on that loop. So now you are going to place a single crochet in the next stitch, followed by an invisible decrease. Single crochet, invisible decrease all the way around, for a total of 12 stitches at the end of this row. Just be careful not to catch the stuffing, so you might want to push it down and out of the way as you go. For your final round, you are going to do a decrease all the way around. So 6 decreases for a total of 6 stitches, but do not cut your yarn at the end of this round. So just decrease all the way around for a total of 6 stitches. All right, once you finish that incredibly frustratingly fiddly round, just pull up a loop so your stitches don't come off. And we're going to turn this sort of funny dumpling into a pumpkin. And for that, you need a really good long length of yarn, about 12 to 16 inches, something like that. Better to have too much than not enough. So once you've left yourself a really generous tail, you're going to pull this all the way through that stitch. and thread up your needle. And the first thing we're going to do is run this needle and this tail end around the outside loops of those 6 stitches that you did. And then cinch those stitches closed. If you want to pop a little tiny knot in at this point, you can. Okay, so to form your little sort of pumpkin sections, we're going to take this yarn, and if you can spot your sort of increases at the bottom, your sort of hexagonal lines, don't worry too much if you can't. We're going to take this yarn and we're going to bring it down one side of his little face and put the needle in the bottom here. With all this excess out of the way for a second, pop your needle in at the bottom. Totally up to you. If you want to go into that center of the magic ring, you can, or just into this round next to it, because this is the bottom of the pumpkin, so you won't see. And then we're going to push this needle and you want to bring it out up the top here. So I'm keeping my thumb on this strand coming down here. And I'm going to bring this needle, crush this poor little chap, up at the top. Pull it through and keep on pulling. So it's pulled all the way through. Now you want to pull it as tight as you want your sections of pumpkin to be. So as you pull, it's going to pull up the bottom and pull in the top and cinch in to create this sort of segment here. So it's totally up to you how you want your pumpkin to look. Every pumpkin is different, and once you're happy with that sort of segment and how it looks, pop a knot to secure it right at the top here. Now this is where we're going to attach our stalk, so don't worry too much, the stalk will cover up all your little knots. I'm keeping the tension on this whilst I do the knot. Now you're going to repeat that for as many segments as you want your pumpkin to be. I'm going to go ahead and do 6 because the next one I like to bring down is on the other side of his face. So 6 tends to work out quite well. If of course you haven't put a face on, you can divvy it up as many times as you like. But repeat the same process. Draw this yarn down the bottom. Push your needle in through the bottom, back out at the top, pull it tight, knot it, and keep doing that all the way around. So once you're happy with your pumpkin segments, give them a little squish around. You can sort of move the strings. You can pop more in if you want to, less, completely up to you. All your knots will be at the top, so the bottom will be nice and neat. pop in a couple more stitches just to secure this tail, and then we can move on to doing the little tiny pumpkin stalk. Just going to weave this end in and bring it out over here somewhere. So grab your brown chunky yarn and your same 4mm crochet hook, and we can do the stalk. Okay, so I appreciate brown is a very difficult color for you guys to see on film, so hopefully by now you'll be able to follow sort of verbal instructions rather than relying just on the color, but I will try to be as clear as possible. We're going to again be starting with a magic ring. Again, if you don't want to do the magic ring, you absolutely do not have to. You can do chain two and work your first lot of stitches into that second chain from the hook. So we're going to place six single crochet into the magic ring. We have six single crochet here, and then we're going to do four rows of six single crochet into all those stitches. So we're just going to go round and round and round and round, six stitches, four rows. So you can tighten this up a little bit, but not all the way closed again. No increasing, no nothing, just a single crochet into each of those six stitches for four rows. So 24 single crochet, if that's easier. Just keep going. So that's 12 that I've done. So I've done two rows, not that you guys can really see, but I'm just going round and round and round. Sometimes it's easier to actually put your finger in when you're doing lots of tiny little rows, short rows like this. All right, that's my last stitch going in there. So you should have like a little thin tube. A decent tail for sewing on. Pull that through. Then your end from your sort of magic circle, use the end of your crochet hook. Shove it in, and if you want to add a tiny tiny bit of stuffing at this point you can, but I don't think I'm going to bother with mine because I had quite a long tail, so I've sort of stuffed it in there. Then grab your needle, thread it up, bring back your pumpkin, and you're going to sew around. See all your knots here. You're going to sew around each stitch in sort of like a round, like that. So you evenly sew around the stem. Now it is a bit fiddly, but bear with it. Then with this final stitch, you want to catch it and you want to bring your hook sort of in so this catches and goes in. Now bring it out at the bottom. So I'm bringing my needle right down to the bottom. So your little stalk is secured at the top. And then I'm just going to bring it into the center of that magic ring and out the other side. Then do a tiny little knot around one of the stitches, if you can. So I've just knotted it around a stitch, and then bring it back up and into the center of your stalk. Then weave it up through a few of your little stitches, out at the top, snip your yarn. And your happy little pumpkin chap is complete. So I really hope you enjoyed this tutorial and you have your little squishy gourd pumpkin friends. They will all look completely different depending on how fat you stuff them, how tight you do your little sort of segment sections. So I hope you enjoyed making your little pumpkin chaps. If you haven't already subscribed, it would be amazing if you just took a moment to do just that. And don't forget to hit that bell notification so you don't miss out on any of my future crochet videos. So until next time, happy pumpkin making. Bye.